and most numbers are uncomputable. So actually, this is the biggest section. This is numbers. This is where numbers are, right? And we have none. So in the main category of numbers, where all the numbers are, apart from a few trivial side effects, right? We know zero of them. You know, as mathematicians, we think we're getting somewhere, but up until now, we have found none of the numbers.
Just put Numberphile out of business.
Yeah, it's a good point. Well, as soon as we find a number, Numberphile can get to work. It's just, we've been dabbling in this, honestly.
So, Matt, presumably the problem is at the moment, if we stumble over a normal number, so we not an artificial one, but we stumble over one by chance, the biggest problem is we have no test or way to know it was normal.
Exactly. I would say pi, probably normal. Root 2, probably normal. We just don't know. And so they're so rare. Numbers, uncomputable numbers are so rare. We have so few of them out here that if we are lucky to come across one, we have no way to test if it's definitely in here. I mean, it probably is, right? Almost certainly, but we have no way of confirming that. So until we get a better way to find and understand uncomputable numbers, and before we have any way of checking for if a number's normal or not, this will remain forever empty.
Do you sometimes feel sad that in all probability, you will die before some of these discoveries are made, and you'll never get to have the excitement of, like, the first normal, uncomputable number?
You know, there's a certain melancholy to knowing that as a human, because you're finite in nature, you only get a little glimpse into mathematical progress. And it's a bittersweet thing looking back, and when you realize that, you know, proving e to the pi was transcendental, happened in the 1930s, well after the people who lived who first came up with the transcendental idea, they never got to see that, right? And Turing finding uncomputable numbers, people didn't get to see that. So we can look back and go, oh, it's a real shame. These people did some maths and they never got to see what came next. So that's sad, and no, that's going to happen again, but at least we have the luxury of looking back and seeing what's happened so far. And so it's a bit sad, but we get to enjoy previous times when it's taken thousands of years for things to build up. We get to enjoy that, we just don't get to enjoy what comes next.